Hi, I'm Idris Elba, and I'm here to chat about the career of Idris Elba. I read somewhere the other day that Idris Elba has been in 100 films. Really? 100 films? Nah, it's not 100 films. I think they must have meant television and films, not 100 films, surely.
Idris Elba's career kicked off in 1994, where we saw him for the first time in Space Precinct, even if we didn't hear him, thanks to some infamously bad dubbing.
Sublight pizza! Hey!
About time. Meet you in the bay.
Thankfully, we soon got the full Idris in the classic British sitcom Absolutely Fabulous.
Hey, has anyone ever told you you look a bit like Sean Connery?
Fab was just like a hoot, as you can imagine. Never forget that, you know. Back in the day, you know, the BBC used to make you rehearse for 5 days. I spent 5 days with Jennifer Saunders, and they were just pissing about. We don't need 5 days for this, we'll just have a laugh. And we did for, you know, 5 days, have a laugh every day. So I really enjoyed that.
There were slightly fewer laughs in the 1998 British sci-fi thriller, Ultraviolet.
I did a show called Ultraviolet, which was on Channel 4, which I loved. I played a character called Vaughan. Fond memories of that.
I suppose you saw where they headed then.
I didn't stick around.
Yeah, I'm glad to hear it. I was worried you were going to do something stupid.
Nah. It's your department.
But it was in 2002 that Idris truly exploded onto our radars as the ice-cold drug kingpin Stringer Bell in The Wire.
You ain't got a dream no more, man. You got real shit. Real estate. We can touch.
Yeah, The Wire was probably the most impactful career move for me. One of the best characters I've ever played, and it came at such a pivotal time for me, you know, living in America for a while at that point and not really getting too many jobs, and then I got The Wire and it completely changed my life. So it was an incredible piece of work, really poignant. I don't think we knew how poignant it was and how it would change the fabric of television making when we were making it, but here it is today, considered a classic. I feel very proud of it, and it really completely launched my career.
After The Wire, we saw more of Idris on the big screen. In 2007, he fought off infected hordes in 28 Weeks Later, rocked some incredible headgear opposite Denzel in American Gangster, and starred as small-time crook Mumbles in Guy Ritchie's Rock and Roller.
Now, that's not very nice, is it?
And proving his comedy chops, he also appeared in The US Office as the uptight pencil pusher and general enemy of fun, Charles Minor.
Okay, are you okay?
I swallowed a crowd!
Having already wowed us as a gangster in The Wire, 2010 saw Idris step onto the right side of the law in one of his most iconic roles, maverick detective John Luther.
Do not worry, you're on the devil's side without even knowing it.
John Luther was a moment in my life where I'd sort of, not plateaued, but I could see a glass ceiling in the type of films I was making. And I was living in America, and you know, my agent said, "Would you fancy coming back to the BBC to work on a detective show?" And I was like, yes. Read the script, and it was like, what a character, right? What a complex, twisted guy that was a good guy. Even though I lived in the States for a long time, I really felt so welcomed home to be asked by the BBC to head a new TV show called Luther. That wasn't written for me specifically, but they just thought I was a good enough actor just to take it. There was no auditions or anything. And I was like, yeah. And that really was a pivotal moment also, because it was when a junction where I came back to the UK and got back into the UK's zeitgeist, if you like.
The amazing news for Luther fans is that Idris will return to the role in a new Netflix film, due to start shooting soon. We cannot wait. While he was clearing up London streets in Luther, Idris was also keeping the peace on a more galactic scale. In 2011, he joined the Marvel Cinematic Universe as Heimdall in Thor. Think of him as Asgard's bouncer. If your name's not on the list, you're not coming in.
I will honor my sworn oath to protect this realm as its gatekeeper.
Yeah, I mean, I've always been a fan of superheroes, and being in the MCU and in the DCU as well, yeah, it feels like being a part of a super team, to be quite honest. I feel like, I think all of us as actors, or, you know, me, Chris Hemsworth, Paul Rudd. You know, we all look at each other and go, wow, how lucky are we that we get to play these characters in these films? So, yeah, I feel very, very happy about that.
Idris played Heimdall in 5 films and is one of few MCU actors to also step into the DC universe, where he blew us, and many bad guys, away as Bloodsport in the smash action comedy The Suicide Squad.
No one likes to show off.
Unless what they're showing off is dope as fuck.
Fuck. That's true.
When he wasn't guarding Asgard, the 2010s saw Idris flexing all kinds of skills. From accordion playing in 2012's Prometheus to piloting a 250-foot mech as the brilliantly named Stacker Pentecost in 2013's Pacific Rim. That year also saw him nominated for Best Actor at the Golden Globes for his performance as Nelson Mandela in Mandela: Long Walk to Freedom.
It is an ideal which I hope to live for and achieve. But if needs be, it is an ideal for which I am prepared to die.
Yes, sir!
We were defending ourselves.
In 2015, Idris appeared in his first Netflix original as the Commandant, the charismatic leader of a guerrilla army in Beasts of No Nation. This was followed by a year of beasts of a very different kind. In 2016, he voiced Shere Khan in The Jungle Book, Sea Lion Fluke in Finding Dory.
Come on, Gerald.
Give us your pail. We'll let you sit on the rock.
Yeah, Gerald.
And a Buffalo police chief in Zootopia. That's almost a whole zoo of Idris Elba.
We need to acknowledge the elephant in the room. Francine.
Happy birthday.
The last 5 years were just as varied, as Idris survived a terrifying plane crash in The Mountain Between Us, defended Jessica Chastain's illegal poker empire in Molly's Game, and put his real-life love of DJing on screen in the Netflix comedy Turn Up Charlie. The man has moves. And that's before he took on Jason Statham and Dwayne Johnson in Fast and Furious Presents Hobbs and Shaw. Most actors wouldn't last 2 minutes against one of them, let alone both. In 2020, Idris starred in the Netflix original Concrete Cowboy, the story of a modern-day urban cowboy living the Wild West dream on the streets of Philadelphia.
Shit, we're gonna do what we always do. We're gonna ride.
And if you thought he looked good in a cowboy hat there, you're going to love The Harder They Fall, a western that focuses on real-life black cowboy Nat Love and his hunt for the ruthless Rufus Buck.
Yeah, I'm a fan of westerns. I like westerns, you know, 310 to Yuma, Unforgiven, these are really great examples. And I never imagined that I'd be in one because they didn't really write black people into westerns, and I just couldn't imagine what role I would have to play, you know. And James Samuels always had this amazing vision. We're old friends, and he said, I can see you in a western and I want to do it. I can see you on a horse. I'm like, yeah, great, because I hate horses. No, I don't hate horses. I love horses, but I'm allergic to them. And here we are. You know, it's a really great story. The story itself is a great story, and even if you don't like westerns, you're going to love the story.
I want you to vacate immediately or die where you lay.
You can see for yourself, as The Harder They Fall is streaming on Netflix now.